the 70th anniversary celebration of the founding of the People's Republic of China, Chinese Ambassador Zhao Zhanhua declared at the podium that China was not out to create trouble in the South China Sea, and that the problems in the West Philippine Sea do not represent the relationship between Manila and Beijing.
More than 60% of China's foreign trade and energy supplies pass through the South China Sea. So China has a greater stake in safeguarding peace, stability, and freedom of navigation and overflight in the South China Sea than any other country.
As a matter of fact, Zhao said, China was hoping that the code of conduct between China and ASEAN in the South China Sea would be finalized soon, specifically while the Philippines is still country coordinator of the ASEAN-China dialogue.
And it's our hope that during the Philippines' tenure as the coordinator, code of conduct could be finalized within 3 years, with the aim of turning South China Sea into a sea of peace, friendship, and prosperity.
Foreign Affairs Secretary Teodoro Loxin Jr. on Wednesday reported that the first draft of the Code of Conduct in the South China Sea has been completed, adding Beijing has softened its stance on controversial provisions.
We completed the first draft. There are objectionable provisions, excluding the Western military presence. They're not holding on to that anymore. The first draft is really just the first draft. We won't know what it's like. I do know that many countries like Vietnam, even Singapore, will take very strong exceptions to anything that would remove a counterbalancing military presence from the region. Mm. They're very careful about that.
But Supreme Court Senior Associate Justice Antonio Carpio warns the public about China's support for the Code of Conduct. Carpio believes that just before China signs the agreement, it will try to reclaim Scarborough Shoal and turn it into another militarized island, all within the term of President Rodrigo Duterte.
My take, China needs to reclaim one area, Scarborough Shoal. They tried to do that in 2016, but President Obama told them you cannot do that. So they sent back their dredgers. We all know they have a plan, and they will do that before the end of the term of President Duterte. After they finish the reclamation, their island building in Scarborough Shoal, they will say, let's sign the code of conduct. Nobody builds anything anymore. Everything will freeze, and that will legitimize what they have created, their artificial islands.
For National Security Advisor Hermogenes Esperon, the government must be left to do its job.
We are in the executive. That is an opinion from a lawyer. But the prosecution or the pursuit of foreign policy is in the hands of the president. So leave it to us.
Meanwhile, the think tank Asia Maritime Transparency Initiative, or AMTI, observes that because China now has artificial islands in the South China Sea, ships of the China Coast Guard are now able to stay at sea for almost the whole year, with some circling Scarborough Shoal and Ayungin Shoal nonstop. What's interesting, says the AMTI, is that these ships are not turning off their automatic identification systems, or AIS. And that could only mean one thing. The China Coast Guard wants the world to know that they're out there and that they're now capable of staying for the long haul. Chiara Zambrano, ABS-CBN News.